thing fish candid.
Nice. Yeah, boy! Yeah. On the hand line!
Me and my mate Julian turned up this morning with all the gear to catch some kingfish in a fishing comp.
Matt,
Liam, only Liam, we found out Matt, we couldn't Luke, use Julian, any of it Liam, when we Liam, had to swap Luke, boats and gear.
Now we can work with this. This
will be fun. Oh, sure we can.
Yep, we can work with this.
We'll make do with the stabby as well. just.
So we've gone back to basics and we'll be fishing in close for kingfish with a modest amount of tackle. And we'll have to catch our own bait. And when fishing in close for kingfish, it makes sense to use what they normally eat inshore. So right now, we're trying to catch some piper for bait.
Quiet little bait, a little bit of burley, and we've got billfish at the back of the boat, piper. Oh, if we can catch some of those, it would be wicked. Oh, you got them? You got them?
Yep.
Yeah, boy. Yeah, boy. First billfish of the season.
Sure is.
Yeah, boy.
Kingfish candy.
Kingfish candy. Kingfish candy. Oh, look at that, I'm excited. We don't have a lot of bait on this boat, so we've got to catch it. So we've pulled in shallow, we've got all of these piper, and all of a sudden I've just forgotten about the competition and the need for bait. I just want to, you know, I'm just focused on catching these fish, and that's the thing with fishing. It doesn't have to be a huge marlin to be a challenge. And these are like, they're neat little fish. I love catching piper. I loved them when I was a kid catching them off the wharf, and it hasn't worn off of me. I just want to catch some of these little critters. And then of course, I do know, as does Julian, that they are really good for catching kingfish.
And we've just seen, not 1 minute ago, a kingfish out the back of the boat. We're anchored in a couple of meters of water and it was chasing the old piper. So we're getting the right bait. Just got to convert it now.
The bigger hook, obviously, that one.
Yep, yep.
Keep it.
Yep. Think I'm on.
Slowly tighten up.
Oh, yeah. Oh,
so we've hooked a kingfish, but because there's not much in the way of any heavy tackle on this boat, we've improvised.
We've resorted to the hand line.
Oh. What's that? It's rubbing on something. Shite.
Oh, shit.
Oh, mate, we might have to chase that. Okay, he's
So now we've got to manage this rampaging kingfish on a hand line while I'm getting used to driving this boat. So, yeah, it's not ideal.
I reckon
he's in it.
Is he in it?
Oh, he's coming up.
Got him out. Go a bit harder, mate.
Oh, shit.
Get out of there. He's here.
You see, you can see him?
Yeah, here's the weed.
Oh, he's been in the weeds, all right. Oh, yes, mate. Hey, on the hand line.
Yeah.
Take your time, take your time, take your time, take your time. Oh, what are you doing with a bit of a knot there? And it's starting to, oh, it's wrapped around their shitty little rod.
Oh, that's not going to hurt if that goes over.
Are you going to grab him in the mouth?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, get to that dog already.
Yeah.
Yeah, boy. Yeah. There's some points there, mate. Far awesome. Out, that is good work,
awesome.
Bro.
Awesome.
Yeah, hand line. Stop to catch piper, little sprat hooks, and look. And look what it's resulted in.
Yeah, bang on 100.
Awesome. 100 points. 100 points.
Oh, God. Hit me in the face.
Sorry.
Which would have been okay if we got the shot.
Sorry, dude.
Oh, got me good.
So our simple plan of live baiting with piper worked, but our old mates here haven't done so well on the kingfish. So I shared a bit of info with them to help them along, and of course I'll share it with you. For starters, to catch piper, look for sheltered water. They don't like rough water. So a bay or a beach with some scattered rocks and kelp is perfect. Anchor up and burley up. Then use a single small sprat hook or a tiny trout hook and about a 6 pound mono leader. Now piper feed on the surface, so have the hook close to the surface, about 30 centimeters or 300 mil below a float. And just about anything will work for a float. So I like to use a small piece of foam, and that's what the guys are using here.
I've just sort of made a bit of a float. It's not, it's a bit, bit rugged, but I've just chopped off a bit of foam, put a slice in it, and put it on the swivel. So it's gonna float our little hook. Piper are notoriously pretty scared of too much going on, so keep it pretty simple. Float along the top. Hopefully we can just watch them and lift them out of the water as they bite it.
While catching piper, you'll often get yellow-eyed mullet and small kahawai. These are good bait also. To rig these small baits for trolling, I like to use a small, strong, non-offset circle hook, like the VMC 6-Baro or 7-Baro Sport Circle. And for trolling these small baits, I like to put the hook up through the bony top jaw. This is the most secure place, and it allows them to troll along in a straight line. For the piper, I like running a sinker to set it down about 10 meters, and the small kahawai with no sinker on top. That's what these guys did, and unsurprisingly, it worked.
Side, yeah boys! Yeah boys!
Yeah!
Yeah!
Oh yeah.
Yeah!
Yeah. And away it goes.
For more tips, how to, and full-on fishing action from all kinds of fishing, you can get it free at ultimatefishing.tv.